All week, we are learning more about the strength of Friday's tornadoes as damage surveys continue.
Meteorologist Luke Vickery has the path, the speed, and the power in today's Weather Now Extra.
So the National Weather Service has sent out their storm survey crews and passed along the information they've found. And these are all the tornadoes that we saw, the tornado outbreak reports from Friday, April 26th of 2024, which is, of course, was last Friday, the tornado outbreak we saw. So we're going to look at the strength of these tornadoes in chronological order of when they touched down, their peak winds, how wide they were, and then also how long they were on the ground, their track. So first tornado of that afternoon and evening, this one started just northeast of Lincoln and moved in towards the Waverly area. This was a strong EF3 tornado. It had peak winds almost to 160 miles per hour, 700 yards wide, and was about 8.6 miles in track from life to death there. So the next tornado, and this was our strongest tornado of the afternoon and evening. It was a high-end EF3 tornado. It started around the Elkhorn area and moved all the way up towards Blair. 165 mile per hour peak winds, and it was about 1 mile wide. Just a massive tornado, and it was on the ground for just over 31 miles. After that, Pacific Junction got in on some of these tornadoes. An EF1 tornado, so one of the weaker tornadoes through our afternoon. Peak winds of only about 100 miles per hour. And, of course, these are estimated as well. 800 yards wide and then about a 2.7-mile track there up to the north. Epley Airfield, and if you were watching our live coverage here, we watched this tornado drop down on Epley Airfield from our exclusive SkyCam network for our Lewis and Clark Monument SkyCam. And this was a strong tornado. It was an EF3 tornado over 500 yards wide. Its max estimated winds were around 152 miles per hour. And it was on the ground moving up to the north and east for about 16 miles. And if you move just south of there, our next tornado in order, Trainer up towards McClelland, another EF3 tornado. So just an absurd amount of EF3 strong long track tornadoes here. This one was on the ground for about 13.3 miles, 800 yards wide, and its max winds about 145 miles per hour. So that's another strong tornado there. As we move up towards Norfolk, this is the next tornado that touched ground. This was in the Norfolk area. Just an EF1 tornado, one of our weaker tornadoes, 100 yards wide. Wasn't even on the ground for a mile, and its wind speeds, max wind speeds, just over 100 miles per hour. And this was our longest track tornado here. The next one in order started around the Minden area and then moved all the way up towards Defiance. This was a strong EF3 tornado, max winds of 160 miles per hour. This one was almost a mile wide, but notice the storm track. This one was on the ground for almost 41 miles as it made its way all the way up towards Defiance. And then after this one ended its life, we had two more start their lives. And we labeled this one number one, starting towards Manila. That was an EF2 tornado, max winds of just over 100 miles per hour, 200 yards wide, 9.2-mile track. And its partner, just to the left of there, that one was an EF1 tornado. It was about half the width of its counterpart, and it was on the ground for about 12.3 miles. And we ended this tornado outbreak with a tornado near Creston, Iowa. You can see the track here kind of falls off the end of the map. That's just because it exited our DMA, so it kind of makes it look like it falls off the end of the earth there, but it is a straight storm track there. Another strong tornado. It was an EF2, but 125 mile per hour max winds, 350 yards wide, and it was about an 8.4-mile track there. So we saw a lot of strong tornadoes that really got uncomfortably close to the viewing area, so I hope this helps you break it down from life to death of this storm event and shows you all the tornadoes we had and then all the strength of them as well. Back to you.